Hello and welcome to another edition of BuzzFeed Unsolved Postmortem, a show where we answer your most pressing questions about the most recent episode of BuzzFeed Unsolved, which was the Bellaire House. All the questions we're answering today came from you guys via our BuzzFeed Unsolved Facebook page and our BuzzFeed Unsolved Instagram page.
Yep.
And as you can see...
Oh, aren't you? I do love that shirt.
Pretty good.
I got a funny shirt too, but I forgot to wear it. You know, I'll wear it next week.
This was given to us by a fan. A very great fan named Simone.
All the way from the Czech Republic.
It's a, really was something, there's like a bunch of notes in here, they're all great.
It's a thumb drive.
And it's a picture of the hot dog on it.
It's got a little Pam on there.
It's cool packaging peanuts, who
doesn't
like
those? Oh, and you can, these are actually edible, I think.
Yeah, put it on your mouth. And then she gave us this amazing book. And basically, it's just a book full of notes from all of you guys compiled across the internet.
This is like
it was actually a
Berenstain Bears level quality of a book.
Genuinely, this was a very, very nice gift. I appreciate it, and I appreciate all you guys out there, so.
Yeah, thanks for watching.
She even has an old Tumblr post for me. I forgot I had a Tumblr.
What does it say in there?
It says, "Set has assassinated my social life, the price you pay for being a film student, but it will all be worth it someday, hopefully." And she referenced that.
You were incorrect. It will all be unsolved someday. So today we're gonna answer some questions.
That's what the show is every time.
Yeah. Here's from that one girl 2612. Do you think the demon possessed Ryan to order the pizza? It did sound pretty hungry, talking about spaghetti and apple taters. Hashtag Shaniacs. Now let's get to the hot dog.
I don't think the demon possessed me to get to order pizza. I'd like to order pizza at all times.
It sounds like you almost always have a little demon in your tummy anyway, because he's always growling at us.
I mean, your tummy makes a lot of weird noises too. Now we truly do sound like an old married couple.
Let's clarify that apple taters are not a real thing.
Yeah, those sound like a real thing.
I'd eat an apple tater.
I would eat an apple tater, so someone maybe get on that. Maybe who would do that? Who's the people that, the Pillsbury Doughboy people? What's the name of their company?
Pillsbury.
That's right.
That's.
this is from Facebook. Maggie Duhigg. I'm really confused because they said it had the most compelling spirit box evidence, but the only thing they really got from the spirit box was the word spaghetti. She's forgetting apple tater.
And apple tater.
Anybody here that was here before this house was built?
Spaghetti.
Spaghetti? Tell us your name.
Apple Tater.
Apple Tater?
Here's my thoughts on that. It looks pretty silly, but that is a portal room that's under a ley line.
Yeah.
You know, it's possible that there is a trickster spirit, maybe like a poltergeisty kind of spirit.
Sure.
Messing with us.
Yeah.
Oh, you want some facts? Spaghetti.
Spaghetti. Apple Tater. This is a big week because we got spaghetti and apple tater. If we can get some confetti, maybe a We Did It banner, because we got the evidence that we've been looking for. We got ghosts. Ghosts are real. Spaghetti and apple tater, the first ghosts ever caught by human beings.
Well, let's go to the next question now.
Oh, I can't wait. Emily Seatbet. Cool name. Hey, spooky boys, it's me, Emily. Hi, Emily. I would like to comment. You're welcome to. When y'all did the spirit box in the attic, it sounded a heck of a lot like the entity was saying, "Who's Emily?" Implying that either Emily is really a ghost whose name was not Emily and who doesn't know she is dead, or Emily is a demon who is trying to mess with y'all. Either way, it's spooky. Thoughts? Hashtag Bogara.
We gotta look at the clip.
Emily, if you're here, say something. Say something. Say something. That house is a place where a lot of things pass through. So it could be that that was just a random thing passing through going, who the hell is Emily?
Oh, cause it was a ghost railroad, essentially.
Yeah, it's a ghost pit stop. See, once again, these are one of those things where like, it could sound like that, but I think it would be irresponsible to caption it that because I'm not really sure if that's what it said.
And again, that attitude is commendable. Let me say that. I do want to reach across the aisle.
Yeah, that's good.
You know,
it's
and
good
say,
every now and then
I respect your discretion.
I actually, that felt genuine for the first time, so I'm gonna take that, yes.
It was.
Yeah, I will reach my hand also across the aisle and we could,
and that
goes back,
it.
No, it goes back.
And that's it, then we're back across the aisle because I am a skeptic.
And now I'm gonna put Purell on my hands.
This guy's nuts.
And wipe my hands.
Yeah, whatever.
Of his weird science germs. Stacia Jors, I swear the female voice that came out of the spirit box at 2118 said, please help me. This is right after.
That's the same thing.
No, that's right
what?
Here.
You know.
Sounds kind of like please help me. Could be please Emily, please help me. I don't know. I mean, I could see either.
I think if there's debate over it, then.
I think it sounds like please help me. I thought that when I was listening to it, but I knew if I put please help me on there,
you'd get
you and all the Shaniacs would be like, you're leading us. You're leading the witness.
Proud of you guys. MacLexus. MacLexus? Pancakes with sweet and sour sauce? I recommend.
I don't. That sounds gross. That sounds like an apple tater.
I'm gonna put this out there. Maybe it's not a good thing to put out there. I think pancakes kind of stink.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
That's dumb.
I don't give a shit.
That's a foolish thing to say.
I eat one pancake, I'm tired of it. A mouthful of mush. Get it out of there. You know what? Waffles? You get that crisp. You still get the mush, but you also get the crisp. And 9 times out of 10, same batter.
How many waffles are you eating?
As many as I can.
That's weird.
I don't care. Waffles kick ass.
You shouldn't judge a food solely on the-
On mouthfeel?
No, you shouldn't judge
I should.
You shouldn't judge food on the fact that you eat inhuman proportions. You eat inhuman proportions.
I'm not eating inhuman proportions.
I'm eating
2 or 3 waffles tops.
That's a lot of waffles.
Small ones.
Okay, see, you didn't disclose that.
Well, now I'm telling you.
I was picturing like an adult big boy
No, no,
waffle.
No, not a big boy
not
waffle.
Not a little fucking Eggo.
I'm eating a little Eggo. Or if I'm
Those
eating a big waffle, I'm
That's
only eating one.
That's not a waffle.
It is a waffle. That's it's not on the a box, waffle. You dipshit.
Yeah, it's an Eggo. It's not even, it's like saying a-
Eggo waffle.
Is a Big Mac a burger to you?
Yes.
A Big Mac to me is McDonald's. It's not really a burger.
But by definition, it is a burger.
I guess.
I don't care if you have some snooty little Hank Will. That's
It's almost like, you know, when they say like-
You know what's a burger is In-N-Out.
In-N-Out is a burger.
That's a burger. Can we get back to the ghosts, Ryan, for once?
Waffles are better.
Yes.
I think waffles are better, but pancakes are still good. Doesn't mean I have to, it's not mutually exclusive.
Yeah, you're right about that.
Sally Regentine, here's a theory for the postmortem. Y'all never pick my questions for the postmortem because my name is Sally and Ryan is obviously still scarred from the Sally house. Hashtag BuzzFeed solved. I am still scarred, but I answered your question, so.
Yeah, what do you think about that Sally?
You got served!
He got you!
Yeah! Yeah! All right.
More! Get her more!
No, I think that's enough.
Come on!
No, that's good. No, that's enough. She gets it. She gets it.
I don't think she does.
I think she gets it. You get it. He got you.
Cat of letters. Unless it's an Irish cat of letters?
No, I think it's cat of letters.
Okay. Not sure if this has been asked before, but have you guys considered doing control tests of the spirit box? Just to see if you get similar results in areas with no reported paranormal activity. It might give you a better idea as to the box's validity. That's a good
idea. And I have an
idea. Okay, well, can we film it, please? My concern, Kat, is that even if we do that in controlled areas, Ryan's just gonna say, well, there's ghosts here.
I mean, I think they're...
Get my papa on the phone.
I think there's no-
We got ghouls. We got a level 5 ghoul.
I think there's no place that doesn't have spirits in it too. That's also true.
Yes, I know you do fall back on that.
Well, it's true.
Back to Facebook, the real, from Devin Murray.
Oh, Devin Murray. The real supernatural happening is that when they're looking for food for the seance, Shane says he only has gum. Then a few hours later, he has goldfish. Where did the goldfish come from? Dun, dun, dun.
I forgot about my goldfish.
That's a food that one handful is enough. 2 handfuls, your mouth starts to get all chalky and dry.
It's a nice measure.
In the end, you have all the shit that you have to kind of like fish out with your finger at the back. That's not fun.
Fish out.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a pun.
I know.
Oh, you gotta play it a little bit cool. Even if you're just talking, you give a little wink while you're talking. Otherwise, you know, I didn't know you were going for a pun.
Hey, I didn't do it.
Frankly, I don't think you were.
I was.
So you just gotta go, you know, you gotta fish it out in the back. Just see that? Just a gentle wink. Just give it a try.
I'm bad at winking.
Are you?
You gotta fish it out. See?
Yeah, perfect!
No, see, I don't like that. See, I don't
No,
like,
that was good.
I don't
you
like
got
the
it.
Act
you
of
got
winking.
It.
The act of winking makes me feel
no,
weird.
No, it's not natural for anybody, but eventually you just start working into your daily life and kind of smooth as butter.
And then you're creepy.
Nah. Creepy? I don't know about that. From Emily,
I don't think it's meant to be said aloud.
Emiloidy. Okay. Shane, what do you think your reaction would be if you guys ever got anything that you considered to be actual evidence of a ghost slash demon? Would you be scared or laughing at Ryan Bergara's inevitable breakdown? Hashtag Shaniac by day, hashtag Bugara by night. Sally House is a pretty good representation of that. It's not evidence that I found compelling because it was just a light turning on and off after a half hour. But, you know, I laughed. And Ryan, you were losing your mind when that happened.
Yeah, I think if you saw a ghost though, like an actual ghost, like a ghost walked in front of you and then just disappeared before your eyes, I do think that would make, I think that would kind of ruin your brain because it would break your sense of reality for a second.
People have to understand, I'm a skeptic, but that just means that I want this to be proven more than anything. I'd love for my reality to be broken a little bit, just a little tear in it.
I don't know what you'd do. I think you would just start shaking.
Maybe you'd
fall over like an ironing board.
I'd fall over, I'd sit up, I'd turn to you and say, I am like you now.
I was wrong the whole time.
What would you, if I was murdered by a ghost, what would your reaction be?
I'd probably be very sad, then I would have to...
You'd be doing this post-mortem alone, like, yes, so Shane's dead.
Shane's dead, I guess, that would suck. I mean, I don't know what I would do in that. I guess the show's over, obviously.
No, you'd go looking for my ghost then.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
That's fun.
Yeah, I don't know, I'm not gonna lie, I don't think I'd be thinking about the show if you died, so that's...
If you died, I'd be thinking about that show.
Okay, well, that's fine. Good moral compass, man. Maria Chocklin, this is from Facebook. One thing that could make or break the paralysis story. Did the dog show any signs that it had been thrown against a wall? Because I call myself a Bugara, but if the dog was fine, I'm calling sleep paralysis, not demons, boys. She's asking about the validity of the dog story. And I can say that the dog did, well, I mean, we didn't see the dog.
We did not.
But she did say the dog walked with a limp the rest of, I think the dog is still alive, but the dog walked with a limp after. The dog's leg was ruined. Oh, don't you dare say it!
I'm saying she did say that.
It lifted her up and it just slammed her up against the wall. And the...
I'm not gonna say anything else.
I'm
in sort of. Nikki Wade from Facebook. I think the reason you guys might struggle to get much evidence is because you are only there for about 8 hours overnight. Like people who have moved into the house, nothing happened straight away. They lived there for a short time before things started happening. Maybe you guys should try a weekend stay somewhere and see if that gets you more activity. Once the ghosts slash demons realize you aren't leaving, they will be more compelled to try to get rid of you. Just a thought. Love your work, guys.
For us to go to a place for that short of time and then see something incredible would be like catching lightning in a bottle, because a lot of these stories, people live there for months before something happens. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of shows don't spend that much time there. They go there for a little bit of time and they come out with some evidence, and I don't know what that's about, but...
could be a little phony.
The odds are always stacked against you when it comes to paranormal investigation, unless you are spending a shitload of time at that place. I think obviously if we did stay a weekend somewhere, we probably would get more, but I ain't gonna do it, so.
That's a lot of goldfish.
That does it for this episode of BuzzFeed Unsolved Postmortem. Make sure you watch the episode this Friday and send your questions in to the BuzzFeed Unsolved Facebook page and the BuzzFeed Unsolved Instagram page, and maybe you'll be on the next postmortem.
What do we got coming up this week?
Ooh, this week is, I think it's up there with Waverly in terms of visually haunting places.
Maybe the scariest so far in the season.
The setting is just so comically horrific.
Yes. It's imposing.
Yes, it is.
Be a good one. Our weekly Q&A concluded. I now welcome you to the part of the show we call the Hot Dog Saga, commissioned by and starring Ryan Steven Bergara, sure, written by me and adored nice by every single viewer. Room. And if you don't like it, you can kiss my buns. In the subterranean caverns of the alien planet Tomod Zero, a holographic core named Maisie sits confined in a pluple prison cell. To her side, the tiny ghost of a hot dog witch named Pam. Okay, look, before you get into whatever thing you're all about now, I have to tell you, I'm not a big fan.
That's fair.
You conjured me from nothing.
That's true.
As part of some pawn in your, I don't know, plot? Or just your stupid disaster of a life?
Uh-huh.
And yet, you bestowed a life of memories into my holographic brain. Didn't need to do that, by the way. That's cruel. You understand that?
I know.
And you even let me know love. True love. Completely unnecessary.
It was a bad move.
Only to drop my wife's ass into an actual volcano.
Hell yeah.
Nope, you better shut up there, witch.
I'm sorry.
And for what? Some petty bullshit that I'm not even a part of. I don't know you, hot dog, and I didn't ask to exist. In fact, I was very content not being. But now, thanks to you, a-hole, I do exist. I feel, I suffer, and I get pissed about stuff like, oh, being stuck in a prison on a planet full of very dumb blue things and their drooling Humpty Dumpty ass king. Or my crewmates, the soup, and my spectacular Grammy-winning brother-in-law, probably being dead as hell in the jungle somewhere. And while we're on the subject, it's worth noting that I'd probably happily die myself, except, oops, I'm in love with a dead, wonderful French fries, and I'm gonna do everything I can to travel back in time to save her ass by, I guess, killing you. Why are you little?
Well,
plop, plop, from the corridor, the call of Joblet the Elder Plupple echoes. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh, that smells like magic. Look, I'm sorry about doing you dirty. I'm a nasty old hot dog witch and you don't trust me. I get it. Plus, I'm little now, and that's probably very confusing. Yeah, why are you there's no time. Here comes Joblet. Hoo-dee-too, la-ra-la-roo.
Shit or get off the pot, hot dog witch. I'm about to get carried off and eaten by a big-ass plupple.
What the hell is a plupple?
It's like a peach, but dumb as hell.
Oh, isn't it very nice to enter a room?
Oh, well, great. You're officially worthless to me, witch.
That's not fair, but I am going to disappear right now. Pam, pam, kazam!
Pam disappears with a poof, just as Joblet the Elder Plupple enters. Good for nothing, witch.
Hmm?
I said, your eyebrows are very thick.
Oh, thank you. Yes, I love them. Anyway, the venerable Dr. Gundus is feeling much saner now, and he requests your audience in his throne room. Perhaps a few parting words before the trial by combat.
Fine.
Also, bit of an update for you. Your crewmates survived the crash.
Oh, great.
But then they were attacked by a pack of feral plupples in the jungle and perished.
What? No, Mike. Jane. They couldn't have. I don't believe you.
Well, always trust a plupple.
Always trust a plupple.
Anyway, off we go to see the venerable Dr. Gundus. Plop, plop, hoo-la-ra!
What does the venerable Dr. Gundus have in store for our holographic hero? How will Maisie press on in the wake of the death of her crewmates? Why is Pam little? Find out next time on the Hot Dogga, and just fade to a screen for a moment for a brief contemplation of the off-screen deaths of Captain Mike Soup and Gene, the greatest character ever written. Now laid to rest on the planet of the Plopples.
Oh, he's dead now?
Yeah.
Well, I actually am glad I have this shirt, Simone, so thank you for that, because it did give me strength through that.
Jean. Sweet Jean.